What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're talking portfolios. So I've been getting this question a lot on how to create a portfolio, what a portfolio has to have to be efficient, or how to get a job with a perfect portfolio. And especially for the topic of Revit, how can you create a portfolio that kind of showcases the fact that you're really good at Revit? And people call it a Revit portfolio. I wouldn't like to call it that way. I would like to kind of split it up into two categories. You're either creating a portfolio that says that you're a BIM manager, or so that's a BIM manager portfolio, or you're just an architect that's really good at Revit. So that's a second kind of a portfolio that you need to be creating, depending on what kind of a job you want to get. But before we get into the whole portfolio, into all portfolios, and I'm just going to be showing you some of the ones I found online that I think are good or have some good elements that you might want to use, I first want to talk about what does it mean actually to have a portfolio. Because I would like to split up the portfolio into kind of two different styles of portfolios. So you have one portfolio which is for a job interview or a job application. So there is a firm that's hiring or that's not hiring, but you would like them to hire you anyway. And then you create a portfolio for this firm specifically, and you either send them by email, or you give them a physical copy of, or you give them a link to a digital portfolio on some website or something like that. So there's that, and then there's like a standalone portfolio that you have that you kind of update over time. That's just a general overview of everything you have done so far. So that's something like LinkedIn or a Behance page or just an Instagram account or a Facebook page, whatever, some sort of a social media page or a YouTube channel, or even a website can work. So that's something different. That's something that you use to kind of promote yourself and your profession and just to show off your knowledge and your expertise. And if somebody decides that they need someone like you, they might see that page and contact you and offer you a job, or some of your friends might kind of recommend you to somebody else that's looking for somebody with that particular skill set. So there's a portfolio that you just use to kind of promote yourself, and then there's a specific portfolio for a specific job application. And that specific portfolio for a specific job application should be really aimed at that particular job. So if it's a company that does, I don't know, it does just wood buildings, so maybe you should do a portfolio where you show off the buildings where you used wood, or some competition where you had a wooden building, or kind of try to adapt your portfolio to that particular company. If you have some good projects where you've done some interior design and the job you're applying to is for a BIM manager, that interior design part shouldn't be like the main part of your portfolio. It should be kind of second tier stuff. The main stuff should be everything about your BIM management. Do you have some experience managing BIM softwares or managing a whole office? So something like that. Just make sure you showcase what's most relevant for the job you're applying for. So that's the most important part as far as having a specific portfolio for a specific job application. But now I'm just going to go over some portfolios that I found online that I think have some good aspects, or just in general to go over some how should a online portfolio look like. So here I am on my computer, and this is the first one I have. This is a Behance page. So this is some guy that Rubens, and I'm not going to try to pronounce that, that made a portfolio about BIM methodology plus Revit portfolio. So he basically starts off explaining what is BIM. So maybe if some firm that isn't using BIM yet would like to hire him to help into that transition, he kind of starts off by explaining what is BIM and then how did he use that for him. So he's got a cool little video over here, which is good. And then he goes off and immediately he goes into some specific construction projects, which is very important because when you're really applying for a job, your student kind of a wild conceptual designs aren't really going to make the cut. You need to take something that's kind of serious and you've calculated the building and you've done everything about the design. As you can see here, he has a kind of a gutter detail, which is important, and here he's got some construction elements, and here he's just showing some of the tables. So for Revit, he's showing that he doesn't only know how to model kind of weird cool shapes, he actually knows how to utilize the whole technology to make the whole process of creating project documentation a lot more efficient and a lot better, or just better. Anyway, let's go on. So he's got another project here, and this one I wouldn't say that the representation is all that good, because this is just kind of a 3D, this is more of a architectural portfolio than a Revit portfolio, but that's okay. If you're looking for an architectural position, this is something you want to showcase. So moving on, he's got a multi-story residential building with some apartments, and here he's showing you all of the apartments. Here I just think that he's missing kind of a regular floor plan where he shows all the furniture, but as you can see here, he did all of the installation, which is quite cool. So he's showing you that he can do all of the plumbing and all of the installations inside of the building, and he can do that inside of Revit. So that's quite cool, the fact that he showed that here. Moving on, he's got a bunch of installations for some projects, some eco burn docks. I don't really understand that, but anyway, he said here he did all the architecture, the layout, fire alarm, telecommunications, electrical, hydraulical, smoke detection, air conditioning. So he did everything here inside of Revit, and he's actually got a video where he's kind of giving you a walkthrough to all of the installations that he's done. So he's basically showcasing that he can do all of those installations on his own. And I think video is always a good representation, maybe not this style of just a walkthrough. You might want to add some voiceover just explaining what you've done. But it's anyway, it's quite cool to kind of show everything that you can do like this. Okay, moving on from this kind of a Behance style page, this there's also these slideshow type portfolios that people use, and this is something that you can use if you're just applying for a specific job. You can create a slideshow portfolio on one of these websites. You've got this ISU, you've got this digital architectural portfolio. Okay, this is just somebody's portfolio, but there's a bunch of these websites like this Prezi, or this is Prezi as well. Yeah, so there's a bunch of these slideshow websites where you can go and just create a slideshow of your portfolio, so you can create particular portfolios for particular job applications or specific job applications. So let's open this up. So he's got a project, and it's all laid out on a title block, which is quite cool. And as you can see here, everything's shown, that the whole project information, everything is very detailed with a bunch of tables over here. Moving on, okay, we've got some wall details, I'm guessing, with some foundation. That's important to show that he understands all of that. So here we've got some 3D views, and what I think about this project, it's just lacking a high quality 3D view, even though this is it's a nice representation. Okay, can we move up? Yeah, this looks nice, but it could be a rendering, it could look a lot better. So this is something that's lacking as far as this project is concerned, but this just shows that this person knows how to create a complete project like this. Moving on, so this is an digital architectural portfolio. So moving on, so we have this another portfolio. So if we open this up and we start scrolling through the pages, we've got some renderings showing the projects, we've got some floor plans, we've got some families that this person created, which is quite cool, just to show that you do furniture design and you can do it inside of Revit. And we've got some decent renderings. Moving on, okay, we've got some classical style building, yeah, with a bunch of renderings. And here it's showing how to do all of the ornaments, stuff like that, which is nice. And this is the end of this portfolio. So this person kind of showed everything. I just think it's lacking a bit more technical stuff, like this project that he has all of these floor plans and details. It's important to show that you know not only how to create a shape of the building, but you actually know how to figure out how that building actually works and how it's built. Okay, moving on, another portfolio. Now this is cool. This is one of these portfolios where you're kind of moving through space, and I think it can look cool, but as you can see, it's kind of slow, and when you're moving through, it's a bit confusing when you're going through these. So okay, you're showing your project here, and as you can see, it's a nice kind of waterfront project. This is a site plan. We've got some elevations here, some more elevations. These are some sections, I'm guessing, or no, these are elevations as well, yeah. And here we got some 3D views. Okay, this is nice as far as architectural design goes, but this isn't really showing the whole project. This is perhaps good as far as kind of showing off your rendering skills. But as far as kind of a Revit job application, I would like to see more of stuff like this. As you can see here, we've got kind of separated everything, showing you the floor plans. Okay, this is the garage, I'm guessing, or something like that. Yeah, here, or no, it's a something, looks like a garage, I don't know. Anyway, so it's showing you the construction of the building, which is quite cool. Again, I would like to see a bit more technical drawings, but this is quite nice as well. Here we've got some interior renderings. So it's just showing you off the whole project. I think the whole platform, wherever you're just kind of spinning around one big plane with a bunch of projects, may be a bit confusing. I would like it to be more linear, but that's okay. If this is your style, I guess, go for it. There's some interior design for a store, I'm guessing, yeah. So here we can see more interior renderings. Yeah, this looks cool. Moving on to the next project. So this is some industrial building. Yeah, but you get the point. So these are just renderings, and I would like to see more details and more technical drawings. So you're really shooting for a mix between kind of a nice renderings and some nice technical documentation, perhaps showing you that you can do some installations, or you can figure out stuff like that. Maybe add some tables where you show you that you can quite efficiently calculate everything. And moving on, so we've got this one. This one looks quite cool, but again, when you're jumping like this from one to the other, it's kind of confusing. And here, these are just simple projects, but as you can see, I'm just going to quickly scroll through this. Let me just move to the other. And here we've got some more complex projects, but as you can see, with this constant zooming in, zooming out, and showing things like that, it can be kind of annoying and irritating, and people might not want to see it through the end. And as you can see here, okay, there is some scaling problems. This should probably be a bit bigger, but you get the point. This person is just trying to show off their Revit skills and how their Revit skills got better over time. But in my opinion, you shouldn't really show off your earlier projects. You should really show off some your current knowledge and your current level at which you're at. So don't bother with some of your early student work. Maybe just some particular projects that are really good. But anyway, moving on. So here we've got a portfolio website, which is quite cool. So this person, Dylan Brown. He's got this dylanbrowndesigns.com website. So he's doing some web design, he's doing some architecture, he's doing some photography. So it's quite cool, and he's showing everything off on his website. And it's not only a portfolio website, he's also got a blog, some photography, some tutorials. He's got, okay, let's see the homepage. Yeah, he's got some posts there. This is, I guess, the blog, and his portfolio. You can see when you open everything up here, he's got some parametric design, and he really explains everything what he did. And if you go to his tutorials, he's actually got some tutorials where he shows people how he figured out something, which is very good because you're showing to your potential employer your skills, and you're showing that you understand everything that you have done. You're showing that you're not really just a part of the team that did a bunch of work and then you're just trying to represent that as your own. You're actually knowledgeable about the things you know. So that's quite cool. So it's cool to have your own website just to show off. And this isn't really for a particular job. This is something that you have up online. And then people, when they see this, they might call you up and offer you a job. So it's quite useful to have. Then we've got this video, which I thought was cool. This is a video portfolio by this guy, Azar, I guess his name is. I think it's very cool to have a video portfolio. Just this format doesn't really work for me because the images are too small and it doesn't really show off the whole project. Maybe you should spend a bit more time to kind of try to efficiently show off your project and maybe explain it. But to have everything in video format, it's actually quite cool. And it's an easy way to kind of share information with your potential employer. So, and it just shows the employer that you're willing to go above and beyond to create an actual video that showcases your work. I think that's quite cool. And one more thing, as far as getting a job in Revit, there are these websites like the Autodesk Design Academy where you can actually post your work up there and people can see it. So for example, this is just a parametric walkway. Somebody did this and they uploaded here, and perhaps somebody who wants to employ a BIM worker or a Revit worker that's good with parametric design, they might see this on this Autodesk Design Academy or similar websites where you can find work like this, and then they can download it and then they can seek out the person because they find the work cool. Okay, so that's pretty much it on portfolios. I hope you have learned something in this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and share this video, and add me on social media because I'll be posting there all the time now, and the links are in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.